When a cruise line claims to have the best technology at sea, you've got to be a little bit skeptical. I've used loads of cruise ship technology over the years, and I've just disembarked a cruise where technology played a huge role. I don't think I went more than about 15 minutes without interacting with some piece of tech, and I had this magic thing on my wrist 24/7. This even came swimming with me. It went far beyond anything I've ever seen on land, but it wasn't without its problems. I put the technology through a series of tests, starting with the most basic tests and ending with things that no other cruise line has even tried. I've cruised with Princess before and they've always been one of my favourite cruise lines, but when I cruised with Princess before, they didn't have any of this technology on board. I had a brilliant time and I don't remember anything being missing from my cruise experience, so I was a bit sceptical as to how this could make my cruise better. I know a lot of you don't like to carry your phones around with you when you're cruising, so I was interested to see if you didn't want to take part in any of this technology, would a Princess cruise still be a good cruise or would you be missing out? Our first cruise ship technology test was to see if the technology could help us to board the cruise faster. A lot of cruise lines now are doing a kind of online check-in, which means that you do as much stuff as you can at home so that you can embark as fast as possible when you get to the cruise port. I will say that before the cruise, the app did seem to have a mind of its own. Sometimes I would be convinced that I've really annoyed the app because it would just be constantly crashing, but then I'd leave it for a while, go back to it, and I would be able to do anything that I wanted. I did manage to get everything done before the cruise and it all worked in the end, but they did kind of squish my profile picture, so I ended up looking like a squashed potato for most of my cruise. I don't know why it went like that. I was cruising on the Sky Princess and the first thing I did when I got on board was to try and find my cabin. I have no sense of direction and I rely a lot on the deck plans and the maps to get me where I'm going. I took this cruise with my dad and me and my dad both have no sense of direction. Usually we rely on my mum and my brother to get us wherever we were going, but we were on our own on this cruise. I'm happy to say that there were deck plans in the app and there were these big screens everywhere that had deck plans, so even I mostly managed to find my way around. I took a cruise last month with Virgin Voyages and they didn't have any deck plans in the apps or any of these screens, and I got so frustrated because I spent so much of my cruise just completely lost. The Princess technology goes beyond just showing you deck plans and they have a feature that is called Get Me There. So if you find something on your phone and you want to get to a specific place, you press Get Me There, and because of this magic thing, it knows where you are and it calculates a route for you. This is the Ocean Medallion. It's about the size of a coin and this is the only thing you need when you're on a Princess cruise. This replaces the traditional cruise card that you'd normally get on a cruise. This is your ID, this is your payment card, this is how you get into your cabin. This is everything you need, and you get this tiny little thing when you check in and you look after it when you're on the cruise. It's this little medallion that allows Princess to work out where you are and where you want to go. I did manage to break it at one point because I wanted to find the retreat pool. I knew that there was a retreat pool on this ship, but it was really difficult to find. You had to go through a certain door. When I asked the app how to get there, it said that there was no available route for me. This was the only time I managed to confuse the app. Every other time it would take me where I needed to go, but when I eventually did get to the retreat pool, I felt extra proud of myself because even the Princess technology couldn't find this pool, and I did find it after a lot of walking around in circles. Princess always have a lot of swimming pools and big swimming pools on their ships. I did brave a swim when we were in Glasgow, a rainy day in Glasgow, and I decided to go for a swim. The great thing about this, the Ocean Medallion, is that it is completely waterproof. So you don't have to get there and worry, where am I going to put my cruise card? Is it going to blow away? It's easier to swim if you have the medallion in this wristband, but more about where I got this later. We did manage to find our cabin, and when we got to the door, the cabin knew that we were there because of this Ocean Medallion, and it just automatically unlocked. It was really good to be able to get into the cabin hands-free. I did try to recreate this Princess promotional leaflet photo. It was very difficult to do, but hopefully you get the idea. One thing that I'm not sure I'm totally comfortable with is the fact that your full name is displayed outside your cabin. I'm sure for most people that isn't a problem at all, and I probably wouldn't have thought about it a few years ago, but now I'm just a little bit more aware and I don't really want people to know where my cabin is. It was really helpful though when I came out on my balcony and I was looking down to the side and I saw Rich and Helen from the Visit With Us YouTube channel just a few cabins down. I didn't have to ask them for their cabin number because I saw their names outside and I could just knock on the right door, so it was very, very useful for that. I was on the first UK sailing for MSC after the pandemic, and they have a similar kind of wristband that lets you into your room. One thing I found strange about the MSC tech was that you could get into your cabin with your wristband, but to turn the lights on, you still needed your cruise card. So you could get in, but you would just be in the dark. It's very common on a lot of cruise ships to have the lights that are controlled by a cruise card so that the electric just isn't wasted when nobody is in the cabin. On our Princess cruise, it still had the kind of light switch that is controlled by a card, but there was just a card that lived in the light switch. So no worries about that. As soon as we got into our cabin, we could put the lights on. Our cabin actually had two TVs and a bath, which isn't something I've ever had before. On the two TVs, you could check the daily schedule, you could watch loads of movies, and you could order room service. I don't normally order room service when I cruise because normally you have to pay for it, you have to phone up, and I can't be bothered to do all of that. But on Princess, room service is included. You can order it on the TV or on your phone, and it always came within about 10 or 15 minutes. It is a little bit dangerous for me to go on a cruise where there is a order cookies to me button that I can press at any time and cookies will arrive on a tray, but I definitely did enjoy it. It's only this part that is the actual ocean medallion, and there are loads of ways that you can customize it. Dad and I were looking on the app before we even got on the ship at the different accessories, and we decided that we wanted to go with these kind of sports watch wristbands. Our next test for the tech was that we wanted to order these accessories on the technology. I've never ordered anything from a shop to my cabin before, but it was really easy to do. We just found these, added them to our basket, and within 2 minutes, they had phoned me to say that they were on their way, and 5 or 10 minutes, they were at the door with these, delivered for free. I decided to pick this wristband in blue. My friend Carol had one in pink, and these ones are $12 each, which I think is really good. You can use these on any Princess cruise. You don't have to buy any accessories, but they do have all kinds of things that you can buy. The default way that you will get your lanyard if you don't pay for anything is just on a lanyard, and plenty of people just keep it in the lanyard. For me, it feels like being at work, kind of having something around my neck, and this was just brilliant. It's so light, you forget that it's there, but it does everything. It wasn't just buying things like gifts that you could do on the app, you could also order things. Like, you could order clean towels, you could order take away my room service trays, anything that you would usually ask housekeeping for, you could just order it, and I assume that they get an alert and they come and do whatever they need to do. I have to admit, I never used this because our cabin steward just always gave us everything we needed, and he was usually around if we needed to ask him for anything. But that is pretty cool. I've never seen no cruise line has ever tried anything like that before that I know of. Inside the app, you'll find the daily schedule and your onboard account. In your onboard account, you can check the transactions, and I always suggest that you do. Usually when I'm telling people to check their onboard account when they're on board, I mean for things like maybe you'll be charged for an extra drink by mistake, maybe an accidental gift shop purchase. My friends Paul and Carol took this to a whole new level. When they checked their onboard account, they found that they had bought $2,000 worth of art at the art auction, which they definitely didn't buy. They did get it sorted out. Princess were very, very apologetic about it, but what a good thing that Paul and Carol checked their onboard account. You don't want to get home and then have that trying to come off of your card. Can you imagine? That would be so stressful. This could happen on any cruise line. It happens all the time. It happens to everybody. So check your onboard account as much as you can. The sooner you see it, the easier it is to sort it out. I have been on cruises in the past where the only way to check your onboard account is to go to reception and get a printout, which is really annoying. But on most cruise lines now, the app, the TV in your cabin, it will show you everything that you have spent. After all of this excitement, we of course did go to find food, and we headed straight to the buffet. When we sat down in the buffet, we noticed that there were these QR codes on the table, and when you scanned the QR codes, it would come up with a menu of all of your drinks. You could order drinks on the app, but there were always crew everywhere. Within about 2 minutes of sitting down, sometimes multiple people would have asked you if you wanted a drink. So we never really used the tech to order our drinks to the buffet. We would just use them to look at the menus and then order through the waiters. To be honest, I don't really know why I'd bother looking at the menu. I almost always have the same thing. It's gonna be some sort of diet cola. I'm definitely team Pepsi, and it was Coke on board Sky Princess. Not the end of the world, but let me know which side you're on. Team Pepsi for the win. After eating in the buffet, we moved to a bar and decided to put the ocean medallion really to the test. I'd heard about some people waiting 15 or 20 minutes for a drink, so for research purposes, of course, I ordered quite a lot of different drinks to quite a lot of different bars and lounges. Ordering the drinks was really easy. All you do is add them to your basket and check out. The person who's making your drink will get your order and they'll also get the photo of you. So it's really important that you look like your photo if you want your drinks to be able to find you. Just use a recent picture that looks like you. The app is already linked to your onboard account, so it knows if you need to pay for that drink or if you have a drinks package. If you need to pay for it, once you've checked out, it will just go onto your onboard account. And then when you disembark the cruise, that will automatically be charged to whatever card you've linked to your account. There was one thing about ordering drinks on the app that I found quite annoying, but I wouldn't be surprised if Princess do change this. You could only order one drink at a time. Sometimes my dad would leave his phone in the cabin to charge, and when we were sat in a bar, I couldn't order him a drink, even though we were both in the same cabin, both had the same drinks package. You can only order one drink at a time, and if I tried to do two, it would charge me for that second drink. I did get an unexpected drinks-related charge, but it wasn't to do with that. More about that later. I do understand the reason behind it. They don't want one person getting a drinks package and ordering all of these drinks for all of their friends, but as it comes with your photo and it has to be given to the right person, they can see that my dad has a drinks package and I have a drinks package, so I feel like I should have been able to order me and dad a drink. Again, I wouldn't be surprised if that's something that Princess change. It was just a bit annoying, not the end of the world. You can still order with the waiters as usual, but you may have to catch them as they are delivering other people's drinks that were ordered on the app. Because the Ocean Medallion tracks your location, you should, in theory, be able to order a drink and then wander off to a different bar, wander back to your cabin, and your drink should follow you. I knew quite a lot of people on this cruise, and I think all of us at one point or another tested this, mostly by accident. A friend of mine, Martin, ordered a drink and then did a YouTube live where he wandered around the ship. His drink followed him and it managed to find him. Of course, please don't make the waiters walk unnecessarily, but it is quite nice if, you know, you're planning to have a drink in your cabin, you order a drink, and then you go to a cabin couple down to meet your friends. It's quite nice in that situation. One evening, I went to my friend Dan's cabin with a few other friends. He had this amazing aft suite and there were 8 of us there on the balcony. To make it easier, because we each had to order our own drinks, we decided to put our drinks together and order at the same time, hoping that the drinks would come on one tray and that we wouldn't make people walk back and forward on the ship. I think our order of 8 drinks came about 4 or 5 separate times, and we did just feel a little bit bad for putting people out and making them walk along the ship. The drinks always came really fast. I think sometimes the fastest way to get a drink was to order it to a cabin, but maybe just a bit more kind of coordination between the drinks orders would make life easier for the crew. I'm sure it's not an easy thing to do. In the app on the phone, there was a decent amount of drinks, but it's kind of like the these are always available everywhere drinks, and there are extra drinks that will only be in specific bars. So if you go to the wine bar, there's going to be more wine than there would be in the app. If you go to a certain lounge, you might find more beer, you might find more cocktails. So there are QR codes in each bar and lounge, and if you scan those, they'll be kind of like, I felt like they were bonus drinks that weren't on the app. Not a problem, but I felt like some people didn't realize that there were all of these extra drinks that weren't on the app to order. I didn't ever see any paper drinks menus, but I'm sure that they have them if you ask for them. There is a limit, a time limit between drinks. I think it might be 15 minutes, but I'm not entirely sure. I did manage to get one accidental charge where I ordered myself a drink, it came, and about 5 minutes later, I wanted to order my dad a beer because he'd left his phone in the cabin, and I did get some sort of charge. I think it might have been removed. It hasn't come off my credit card yet, but still just be aware of that. There normally is a time limit between drinks. Not found it to be a problem, but just be aware of it. Ordering drinks on the app was cool, but there was another feature that I think I enjoyed even more than that. I did some filming with my friends Paul and Carol. The video will be on their channel soon. And after I was done, I wanted to locate my dad. If you're on a cruise with no internet, trying to find somebody on a ship is almost impossible. The ships are so huge, and when the other person can also move, it makes it very difficult. In the app though, I could see my dad's location. I could see almost where he was sat, and I found him there in the buffet with a snack, and a beer. It was amazing. You do have to specifically allow your location to be shared. It's not as if anybody can see you, but once you've requested someone's location and they give it to you, you can see them on the map, which was really cool. We would often be sat in the theatre or sat in a lounge and we would be like, oh, let's have a look and see where the ocean medallion thinks we are. And it would be spot on. Not just where you are, as in I'm in the theatre or I'm in the lounge. You could see where we were sat in the theatre within a couple of metres. There were some places on the ship where you couldn't order drinks to them. They were kind of drink black holes. You couldn't order drinks to the theater, for example, because they don't want, you know, drinks orders coming in and messing up the show. If you have a drink, you can bring it into the theater, that's no problem, but you can't, through your app, order a drink to you in the theater, which would be really annoying if everyone kept ordering drinks during the show, so that makes sense. We couldn't use our phone to order drinks in the theatre, but we did use our phone as torches for when it was dark and there was a slow song. A friend of mine, Ross, was singing and he was absolutely amazing. Not only just a good singer, but also a good showman, which I think you need for cruise ships. I would love to show you a clip. All of the entertainment on Princess is pretty amazing, but YouTube will not let me do that. Your Britishism of the week is torch. A torch in the UK is what you guys in the US call a flashlight. I'm pretty sure it's only the US that calls this a flashlight and that the rest of the world is on Team Torch, but let me know if you call this a torch or a flashlight. Finding your friends and family on the app was really cool, but sometimes there's something you need to find that's even more important. You could go on the map and you could press the toilets button and it would pop up with where all of your closest toilets were. I know that's a small thing, but sometimes it's those small things that really makes your cruise better. You don't want to trek halfway across the ship and there's a toilet just the other way, but you always know on Princess. I don't think my next cruise will have anywhere near as much tech on board, but it's definitely gonna be an interesting cruise. To find out why I've booked my first Disney cruise and how I booked it as cheap as possible for a Disney cruise, watch this video next.